Welcome to today's edition of The Good, The Bad and The Ugly, especially curated from the world of economy and business today. I'll start with the good. The Reserve Bank of India has turned on the heat on public sector banks regarding letters of undertaking. The Reserve Bank of India has asked all the lenders to provide details of all LOUs issued as well as amounts outstanding. It has also asked the banks to provide details of whether they were issued against pre-approved limits and whether banks had enough margin money against these LOUs. The details sought go back to 2011, when the PNB fraud is supposed to have started with Nirav Modi's companies. These are part of RBI's new guidelines against 24 odd checkpoints that the regulator wants the banks to go through and implement. These include connecting their SWIFT software with the core banking software. All these measures are good for banking system in general. Now to the bad. The Unique Identification Authority of India has flagged off low Aadhaar enrolment and updation by 2,500 branches of the 7,000 odd branches that have started enrolling and updating Aadhaar. Only about 7,000 of these branches of the 14,000 bank branches that are supposed to do it are enrolling and updating Aadhaar just yet. The 2,500 branches that are falling short of UIDAI's expectations are enrolling or updating less than 16 Aadhaar accounts every day. The UIDAI expects upwards of 16 and going up to 40 to 50 Aadhaar updates every day from each branch. Such a slow pace of updation is bad, and UIDAI has asked the banks and their branches to actively contact customers to update their Aadhaar. And now to the ugly. Promoters of bankrupt companies have begun to exploit the current judicial system to delay insolvency proceedings. The promoters of SR Steel, Videocon Industries as well as Built Paper have approached the courts against the current resolution process that's going on in NCLT. It has long been feared that just as the previous resolution processes that RBI had started, the current IBC process may also get bogged down in the court processes. In the India Today conclave, Kotak Bank Chairman Uday Kotak had warned that promoters may try and bog down the insolvency proceedings in courts. Multiple applications filed against the ongoing insolvency process in the NCLT is ugly because the same promoters did nothing as far as the preceding process of corporate insolvency resolution process is concerned. This is what makes this truly ugly. If you enjoyed watching this content, please like us on our Facebook page.
Our Facebook page, www.facebook.com/businesstoday. Follow Business Today on Twitter India at BT_India and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Business Today India.